Trump has it absolutely right. We do need physical barriers on the border. The first thing that we have to tackle is we have to secure our borders to ensure that 20 years down the road, we're not gonna have another 30 million people in the United States. We have to detain these individuals and hold them pending their deportation proceedings. If we continue with the catch and release policy and program, we will continue to see people coming to the United States to game the system. One of the things that President Trump has campaigned on is we need to build walls in strategic locations, which then allows the Border Patrol, people like myself, to dictate where illegal crossings will take place. It's already worked. It's had huge, it's paid huge dividends in San Diego, California, and El Paso, Texas. And if we continue to expand upon what we've already done and we put walls in strategic locations, it allows the Border Patrol to dictate where illegal border crossings take place. It will allow us to be a lot more effective, and Trump has it absolutely right. We do need physical barriers on the border.
Build that wall, 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 build that wall.
They understand that that message of don't come here is not going to be enforced. They understand that all they have to do is come here, break our laws, and they'll still be released into the United States with a court date that they're supposed to show up for a deportation proceeding some 2 years down the road, and they just never show up. And that's invited so many people to come to the United States and break our laws.
You actually are allowed to seek asylum in this country.
They're going to declare asylum.
Asylum seekers who legally would be able to ask the government for a reprieve.
They're economic refugees. They don't have a credible fear to be in the United States. They come here waving their flag of the country that supposedly is oppressing them. They keep their identity. They don't come to the United States to assimilate, to make this country great, but they're coming here and they're breaking our laws, and they're knowingly doing it, and groups like Sin Fronteras, they're encouraging them to break our laws. Thankfully, the vast majority of United States citizens, they want to have a free country. They want to have the laws of the United States because they understand that laws actually make us free. The laws are what made this country great. We're the most prosperous country in the entire world because we have laws. We're also the most prosperous country in the entire world because we have big hearts and we do care about people. We allow more people to immigrate to the United States than any other country in the entire world. Yet people take advantage of our goodwill and our generosity, and that's what gets the American public upset. And to see people try to make us out to be bad people because we're doing the laws, we're enforcing the laws that the United States Congress, and that includes Democrats and Republicans, passed, it gets very frustrating and demoralizing to our Border Patrol agents.
I believe you should get rid of it, start over, reimagine it, and build something that actually works.
I think there's no question that we've got to critically re-examine ICE and its role and the way that it is being administered and the work it is doing, and we need to probably think about starting from scratch.
I think we need to abolish ICE.
We should abolish ICE. We should create something better.
99.9% of police officers, Border Patrol agents, ICE agents are extremely good individuals. Unfortunately, all we ever hear about is the bad ones. We don't hear about the good ones and all of the good that we do. If he had the support that he needs, if people from the agency and Congress would catch his vision, we would in fact be able to secure our borders. We would then be able to deal with those individuals that are currently here in the United States illegally, and we would be able to prosper as a country.